Okay, so let's just say I don't think quick enough in order to react to it, and he does manage to get me down. Go ahead. No. Grab around and hook my legs and get me on the ground. Okay, I'm on the ground. He gets on top of me. Get on top of me. Here. Okay, he's straddling like this, and I'm trying to get out of it. Okay, so once he gets to this point where he's about to start throwing punches at me, like this, I got my hands up, right? Okay, but here's what's dangerous about grappling in the street and being on your back, where a lot of people say, you know, you can still, you know, that it's a good thing, and you want to come up and cross in and try to hook him down and bury your head, right? A lot of times, if I'm punching at him, boom, like this, he's gonna come back up, so I can't reach him and I can't punch into him. If I'm punching into his stomach, he's gonna be trying to block my punches into the stomach, right? If I'm trying to punch in here, he's gonna block down here, okay? But as he's coming into me and he's punching on top of me, and I can't get him off, here's the danger in actual street fight right here. You see it? If I'm hooked inside here, he's dead. He just died because he didn't watch my hands. And that's what happens in street fight versus ring fighting. And I walk away and he dies. So if you're in a grappling situation on the street, you gotta always be aware of where their hands are. And you cannot bury your head in a grappling situation on the street, because the moment you do, regardless of the situation, here, lay down on the ground.